Now, I'd like you to form small groups and discuss your experience of new methods of wound management used in your country. Anne, can I ask you some questions about your experience first?
Yes, sure. Well, for non-healing necrotic wounds, the hospital I was working at used larval therapy. The maggots debride non-healing necrotic wounds very well. We use them on pressure ulcers.
Was it successful?
Surprisingly, yes. The maggots are specially bred in sterile conditions and are placed under mesh in the wound bed.
Why do you use mesh?
Basically, it stops the larvae escaping. The mesh is covered with moist swabs every day to prevent the larvae from drying out. The larvae are replaced every few days until the wound can be treated with conventional dressings.
Was that the only treatment you used?
For chronic wounds, our hospital has had some success with hyperbaric oxygen therapy. As you know, this enhances the wound healing process and increases growth factors. It also has antibacterial effects. That's the upside. The downside is access to the equipment and, as always, cost. What about you, Henry?
I've had quite a bit of experience using vac dressings. We have a vac machine on our unit.
What's your vac dressing change protocol?
We use gentle irrigation to clean the wound. It's important to cut the foam to the size of the wound. That avoids maceration of the wound edges.
I see.
Then you place the end of the drain tube over the first layer of foam and cover with another piece of foam.
Then the transparent membrane seal, right?
Yeah, that's the most important part. If you don't get it right, you don't get the vacuum action. Then you connect the other end to the vac unit and program it to produce the required level of pressure. Once the vacuum is switched on, the air is sucked out of the foam. This causes it to collapse inwards, drawing the edges of the wound in with it.
Very interesting to know. Thanks, Henry.